गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी चैप्टर 14 फंडामेंटल ऑपरेशंस। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल नो हाउ टू ऐड अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस। सो हियर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट एडिशन ऑफ सिंपल एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ मोनोनोमियल्स। सो वी नो दैट व्हाट इज मोनोनोमियल्स। मोनोनोमियल्स एंड अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ वन टर्म्स like binomials which having two terms, trinomials which having three terms. So about these things we have studied. Also about the what is polynomials, we know that what is terms, what is how to find the degree. So about these things we have already studied in the previous chapter. So now we will study how to add the algebraic expressions. So first of all, we should know, it is very important, we can add or subtract only like terms. So like terms, so what is like terms? Again, I just make you, give you the idea of like terms. What is like term? Like terms, it is also called the similar term. Are the term which have same literal factors. Literal factors means which is that variables, which is the coefficient, which is letters. That is literal factors, like 4x. If I say 4x, so there x is your literal factor. Okay, so if that 4x, so that is if 4x 6x, so there is, if there is a 4x, suppose you can see here the example, you can see the example here, that is 3x and 4x. So in 3x the variable is only x, and 4x also the variable is x. So we can say the like terms because it's a variable is same, similar variable. We will not see the constant term. This constant term may be different, like a 3 and 4 is there, but only we will see the literal factors. Literal factors means the variables we will see, that variable are same or not. So that will be called like terms. Unlike, they will be the different. Different means that variables will be different. Like suppose 3x square plus 4x. So there is x square, and in another term I told 4x only. So they are not like terms because its literal factor are not same. Literal factors means the letters, that variables letter, that should be same. That is your literal coefficient. Okay, like 5x. So in that x is your literal coefficient. 5 is also coefficient of x, and what is the coefficient of 5? That will be x. Okay, so that 5 is your constant coefficient, but that x is your literal coefficient. So that is about like terms and unlike terms. Okay, so what we can do here, so this very important, you must know, we can add or subtract only like terms. We can add or subtract only the like terms. We cannot add or subtract the unlike terms. So you must remember this one. This is very important one. We can add or subtract only the like terms. Got it? Okay. We cannot add or subtract unlike terms. As I told that, we cannot add or subtract unlike terms. In this case, you can see 5a plus 8b. So here you can see a is the one type of variable. B is also the variable. A is also variable. B is also variable. But both are same? No. A and B are not same type of variable. So that's why we cannot add. Here also see M and N. So M and N are also variable, but they are not same kind. Here you can see, here is the A, and also here is the 3A and 8A. But you can see A in the both term, in the first term 3A, in the second term 8A. In the both term you can see the variable is A only. So that's why we can add. So that 11A. Here also you can see 25P and 17P. Both the term, in the both term you can see the variable is only P. That's why we can subtract. So if there is like terms, then we can add or subtract. But if there is unlike terms, you can see in the first term 8x, in the second term 9y. The variable of the both terms you can see here is the x and y. They are different variable, so we cannot add or subtract. Got it? So you must remember this one. We can add or subtract for only if they have like terms. Like terms, you know what is like terms? I hope you understand. Okay. So now the rules for the addition of compound expression. Write each expression in separate row in such a way that like terms are arranged in one below the other in columns. Just to see the example, you will understand better. 2a plus 3b. So we will write this 2a plus 3t, 2a plus 3b in a one row. Now 3a plus 4b we have written in the another row. And what is the common? You can see these like terms, you can see they are just below of that. 3b and 4b, they are just below of that, they are in the one column. See, 2 also, you can see this, they are in the one column. See, 8b, so like terms are in the one column, then we can add it easily. So what you have to do, you have to write in a such a way that you have to write in the row wise, but when you will add this addends, so this first addend and second addend, if there are three are there, so three addends will be there, but all the same type, like terms you have to write in the one column. Okay, see here, like terms are written in the one column, then we can add. Okay, also three are there, see, all the like terms in the one column. Got it? All the like terms in the one column, then after we will add according to the signs, sign plus minus that we will use. First of all, you have to arrange that nicely. You have to arrange all these like terms, you have to write in one column. See this also. So this like terms is written in the one column, all the like terms written in the one column. But you can see here it was no any value was given, so this place was kept blank. So if there was not same type of variable is available, same type of terms is not available there, so what we can do, we can kept that blank. So here it is like that, it was kept blank. Okay, so add similar terms mentally, then write the result. So what you can do, the similar terms you can add mentally in your mind, also you can calculate easily. So that I will tell you how to add it also, we will discuss, we will study about that. So, and also very important one, this rules of addition of integers, this already you have studied in chapter 3, page number 57. You can see page number 57, chapter 3, you can see that page number 57, chapter 3, there is the rule of addition is there. So that rule is that if you can see same term are there, means plus plus are there, what we will do, simply we can add. If there is the minus minus sign there and we have to add, what we will do, we will add first that, because minus minus plus, so what we will do, we will add 32 plus 18, so that's the result will be 50. But we will put the sign, we know that how we will put the sign, according to the sign of the larger number, bigger number. So we among this 18 and 32, which is the largest number, 32, what is the sign before 32, minus sign, that's why right here minus sign. So that sign will always decided by the larger number, which will be the bigger number before that, which sign is there, that sign we will use in the result. Same here, plus minus is there, so we know that plus and minus, so that will be minus. So among 42 and 18 there will be subtraction. So first we will subtract 42 minus 18, so answer you will get 24. Then after we will see which is the larger, bigger number. So 42 is the bigger number, and before that bigger number 42, which sign is there, minus sign, that's why in the result we will use the minus sign. That's the concept. So already you know about these things. If you forget this one, you again go through this chapter 3, page number 57, or you can see my previous video and you understand it nicely. Okay, so and one more table I made for you, you must remember this one. This table is for if we have to add, what we have to do if we have to add. Okay, in the addition, if two numbers as given, first one is in the plus sign, another is also in the plus sign, so what we have to do, we have to add, we have to, what we, if both the numbers given number in the positive sign, so what we will do, we will add. Agar do number hai, dono number mein plus sign hi hai, to aapko kya karna hai, add kar dena hai. Add karne ke baad aapko fir decide karna hai, jo bhi bada number hoga, bade number ke samne jo bhi sign hoga, wo sign aapko result mein use karna hai. ठीक है, बट आपको अगर दो प्लस है तो पहले क्या करना है, प्लस करना है, उसके बाद साइन आपको कैसे लगाना है, उस दोनों नंबर में जो सबसे बड़ा नंबर होगा उसके सामने जो साइन होगा वो यूज़ करेंगे. ठीक है, अगर एक में प्लस है एक नंबर में, दूसरे नंबर में क्या है, माइनस है, ये वाला एक में प्लस है दूसरे में माइनस है, तो आप क्या करेंगे, उस दोनों के बीच क्या होना है, उस दोनों नंबर के बीच में आप क्या करेंगे, सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे. ठीक है, सब्ट्रैक्ट करने के बाद या आपको क्या करना है, फिर से वही सेम रूल फॉलो करना है, जो भी बड़ा नंबर होगा उसके सामने जो भी साइन होगा वो आप यूज़ करेंगे. ठीक है, सेकेंड क्या है, सेकेंड कंडीशन, थर्ड कंडीशन, अगर एक में माइनस साइन हो और एक में प्लस साइन हो तो उस दोनों के बीच भी क्या होगा, माइनस ही होगा। पहले आपको उस दोनों के बीच माइनस करना है, इसके बाद आपको साइन फिर वही सेम रूल फॉलो करना है, जो भी नंबर बड़ा नंबर होगा उसके सामने जो साइन होगा वो साइन लग जाएगा, ठीक है। फिर आपको फोर्थ वाला क्या है, दोनों अगर माइनस में है, ठीक है, ये भी माइनस में और पहला नंबर भी माइनस में और सेकंड नंबर भी माइनस में, दोनों नंबर माइनस में और उस दोनों के बीच आपको ऐड करना है, तो आप क्या करेंगे, उस दोनों के बीच क्या होगा, पहले एडिशन हो जाएगा, ठीक है। एडिशन होने के बाद क्या करना है, आपको एडिशन कर देना है, इसके बाद फिर आप जो भी नंबर बड़ा होगा उसके सामने वाला साइन उस रिजल्ट में लगा देंगे। तो इस पूरे टेबल में आप एक चीज़ आप कॉमन क्या देखें, आप इसमें से कॉमन आपको मिलेगा, अगर सेम है प्लस और प्लस है तो रिजल्ट आपको क्या करना था, प्लस ही करना था। अगर दोनों में माइनस था, ठीक है, अगर आपको दोनों में माइनस साइन नहीं था, ठीक है, आप जैसा आप यहाँ पर देखो दोनों में माइनस है यहाँ पर, तो अगर यहाँ भी माइनस था और यहाँ भी माइनस था, आपने क्या किया था, प्लस किया था। इसका मतलब है अगर सेम साइन हो तो क्या करना है, प्लस करना है, ठीक है, और अपोजिट साइन हो तो माइनस करना है। अब आपको जैसा इजी हो याद करने में आप याद कर लो, ठीक है, आपको याद करना है अगर प्लस प्लस है तो प्लस, प्लस माइनस माइनस, माइनस प्लस माइनस, माइनस माइनस प्लस, ओके। नाउ वी विल सॉल्व आवर एक्सरसाइज 14A, सो लेट्स सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 14A। सो हियर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ऐड, वी हैव टू ऐड, ओके, सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। सो यू हैव टू ऐड 5x, 5x, 2x एंड 3x, दिस ऑल फोर टर्म्स यू हैव टू ऐड। सो हाउ यू विल सॉल्व, फर्स्ट, ओके, सो फर्स्ट यू विल राइट x, सो यू राइट देयर x, एंड व्हाट आई टोल्ड दैट यू हैव टू अरेंज इन द कॉलम, कॉलम मीन्स, देन आफ्टर नेक्स्ट नंबर आई विल राइट हियर 5x, एंड ऑलवेज यू हैव टू सी दैट, आपको हमेशा क्या देखना है, ये x के नीचे x ही होना चाहिए, ठीक है, ये हमेशा एक जैसा एक साथ होना चाहिए, जैसे आप अरेंज करते हो ना एडिशन में, एक वंस के नीचे वंस, टेंस के नीचे टेंस वाला, उस तरह से आपको अरेंज करना है इसको भी, ठीक है, इन द सिमिलर वे वी विल अरेंज इट आल्सो। नाउ नेक्स्ट नंबर, नेक्स्ट टर्म इज गिवन 2x, थर्ड वन इज गिवन 3x, एंड नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल ऐड इट, ओके। आपको क्या देखना है, अगर किसी नंबर के सामने कुछ भी नहीं है, यहाँ पे आपका क्या था, कुछ भी नहीं दिया हुआ था x के सामने, तो कुछ नहीं तो क्या है, 1 है, क्योंकि आपको पता है किसी नंबर को आप 1 से मल्टीप्लाई करो या फिर उसको डिवाइड करा दो, आपको सेम नंबर मिलने वाला, सो यू विल गेट द सेम नंबर। सो नाउ वी कैन ऐड इजली, नेक्स्ट स्टेप, व्हाट यू हैव टू सी, दिस वेरिएबल पार्ट्स, आपको जो वेरिएबल पार्ट्स दिख रहा है एक्स एक्स एक्स, सारे सभी में एक्स है, तो आपको क्या करना है, इस सभी पार्ट्स के बदले जितना भी एक्स है अभी इसके नीचे आपको सिर्फ क्या लिख देना है, एक्स, ठीक है, ये एक्स ऐड नहीं होगा, लाइक एक्स एक्स एक्स, 2x, 3x, ऐसे नहीं होगा, आपको क्या करना है, सब जितना भी एक्स है उसके बदले आपको क्या करना है, एक एक्स लिख देना है, इस सभी एक्स के बदले एक एक्स हो गया, ठीक है। नेक्स्ट स्टेप, अभी आपको क्या करना है, इस वेरिएबल टर्म के लिए आपने एक्स लिख दिया, अब आपको कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म देखना है, ये कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म है इधर, कॉन्स्टेंट कॉफिशियंट जो भी है, अब इसको ऐड करना है, आपको जैसे आप अर्थमेटिक में ऐड करते हो, नॉर्मली ऐड करते हो, वैसे ही करना है, तो 1 प्लस 5 6, 6 प्लस 2 8, 8 प्लस 3 11, सो योर आंसर विल बी 11x, ओके, तो आपका आंसर क्या हो गया, 11x। क्यों अभी हमने सिंपली ऐड कर दिया, क्योंकि यहाँ पे सबके आगे कुछ नहीं तो क्या साइन था, प्लस साइन था, इसलिए हमने इसको इजीली ऐड कर दिया, अगर डिफरेंट साइन होता तो फिर हम लोग वो रूल फॉलो करते, जस्ट जो हमने अभी आपको टेबल में रूल बताया, ठीक है, तो इसका आंसर हो गया 11x। सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी विल सॉल्व, देन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड मच बेटर। सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। सो 5b² एंड सेकेंड टर्म इज माइनस 3b², ओके, सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, दैट इज फर्स्ट वी राइट 5b², ओके, एंड द नेक्स्ट इज गिवन माइनस 3b². सो ऑलवेज यू हैव टू राइट इन द कॉलम वाइज, एंड द वेरिएबल्स यू हैव टू राइट जस्ट बिलो दिस वेरिएबल्स यू हैव टू राइट बिलो ऑफ दैट, ओके, सेम वेरिएबल्स यू हैव टू राइट बिलो ऑफ दैट। नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू ऐड दिस ऑल, सो नाउ हाउ यू विल ऐड, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एज आई टोल्ड दैट दिस वेरिएबल यू विल राइट द सेम, सो आई विल राइट हियर b². नाउ सेकेंड इज देयर, हियर इज नथिंग बट विच साइन इज देयर, एज यू नो वेरी वेल, इफ देयर इज नो एनी साइन बिफोर एनी नंबर और एनी डिजिट, इट मीन्स देयर इज अ प्लस साइन, सो नाउ हियर इज द प्लस साइन, एंड सी हियर, हियर इज द माइनस साइन, जस्ट नाउ आई टोल्ड दैट प्लस माइनस ऑलवेज माइनस, प्लस माइनस माइनस, सो इट मीन्स बिटवीन 5 एंड 3, अभी क्या हो गया, प्लस माइनस क्या हो गया, माइनस, इसका मतलब क्या है, 5 और 3 के बीच में क्या होगा, माइनस होगा। तो 5 में आप 3 को माइनस कर दो, कितना मिलेगा आपको, 2। ठीक है, अभी 2 हो गया। अब आपको क्या देखना है, साइन लगाना है। अभी जस्ट हमने टेबल बताया था ना आपको, कि आपको इस टेबल के हिसाब से आपको अरेंज करना था। जैसे प्लस माइनस, माइनस हो गया, ठीक है, अभी देखो माइनस था। नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू आफ्टर डूइंग दिस, वी विल सी दैट विच इज़ द ग्रेटेस्ट नंबर। आपको बड़ा नंबर देखना है, इसमें बड़ा नंबर कौन है, 5 और 3 में 5 है, तो 5 के सामने कौन सा साइन है, प्लस साइन, इट मीन्स हेयर विल बी आल्सो प्लस साइन। सो इट मीन्स योर आंसर विल बी प्लस 2b² और सिंपली यू कैन राइट 2b². सो दैट्स योर आंसर, गॉट इट, ओके। नाउ वन मोर क्वेश्चन आई विल सॉल्व हियर फ्रॉम हियर, नंबर 4। सो नंबर 4, 4 टर्म्स आर देयर, 2x माइनस 7x 4x एंड देन आफ्टर माइनस x। सो हाउ वी विल सॉल्व दिस, सो लेट्स सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। सो वन नंबर इट इज 4, सो 4 टर्म्स आर देयर, सो फर्स्ट टर्म इज देयर 2x, सो आई विल राइट हियर 2x, देन आफ्टर इज गिवन माइनस 7x, सो राइट माइनस 7x, देन आफ्टर इट इज गिवन 4x एंड इट इज नथिंग इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट, इट इज मीन्स प्लस साइन, देन आफ्टर माइनस 1x, ओके। सो हियर इज ऑल्सो नथिंग बट प्लस साइन इज देयर, ओके। नाउ एंड ऑल दिस वी हैव टू एड, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द वेरिएबल्स वी राइट द, फॉर द वेरिएबल्स वी राइट द सेम, सो x, सो हियर आई विल राइट द x। नाउ वी विल सी हियर दिस, फर्स्ट यू दिस टू वी विल एड, ट्राई टू एड दिस टू, सो हियर इज द प्लस साइन, हियर इज द माइनस साइन, सो प्लस माइनस माइनस, इट मीन्स बिटवीन 7 एंड 2 इट विल बी सब्ट्रैक्शन, सो 7 माइनस 2 5, सो दैट 5 एंड व्हाट विल बी द, व्हाट विल बी द साइन, सो साइन, व्हाट इज द साइन बिफोर द बिगर नंबर, माइनस, सो राइट हियर माइनस, देन आफ्टर प्लस 4 इज, नेक्स्ट टर्म इज प्लस 4, सो प्लस 4, अगेन यू कैन सी प्लस माइनस, दिस प्लस माइनस माइनस, सो बिटवीन 5 एंड 4 देर विल बी सब्सट्रैक्शन, सो 5 माइनस 4 1, एंड विच साइन विल बी देयर, 5 इज द बिगर नंबर, इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट माइनस साइन, सो वी पुट द माइनस साइन, ओके। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज दैट माइनस 1, सो नाउ दिस माइनस 1 वी विल ऐड, सो माइनस, सो माइनस माइनस प्लस, सो 1 1 1 2, देन आफ्टर विच साइन विल बी देयर, माइनस साइन, सो बोथ आर सेम एक्चुअली, सो वी कैन राइट द माइनस साइन, सो बिकॉज 1 एंड 1 बोथ आर द, देर इज नो एनी लार्जर नंबर, बिगर नंबर, सो द सेम साइन इट विल बी यूज, सो माइनस 2 विल बी देयर, सो नाउ हियर विल बी माइनस 2, सो व्हाट इज द आंसर, माइनस 2x, सो लाइकवाइज यू हैव टू डू, ओके। सो वन मोर क्वेश्चन यू कैन सी दैट फ्रॉम देयर, नंबर 8, सेम क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, एट नंबर क्वेश्चन इज दैट 3a प्लस बी, ओके, एंड अनदर टर्म इज गिवन 6a प्लस बी, सो नाउ हाउ यू विल ऐड, सो वेरी इजी, सो यू जस्ट कंसिडर दिस एज ए वेरिएबल, दिस a प्लस बी एंड a प्लस बी यू जस्ट कंसिडर्ड एज ए वेरिएबल एंड यू राइट द सेम एग्जैक्टली, सो एग्जैक्टली यू राइट a प्लस बी, ओके। नाउ यू कैन सी दिस कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म्स, सो 6 प्लस 3 9, सो योर आंसर विल बी 9 अंडर ब्रैकेट a प्लस बी, सो दिस योर आंसर, ओके। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, सिंप्लीफाई द फॉलोइंग, सो वी हैव हियर आई विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, आई हैव टू सिंप्लीफाई, सो इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 द टर्म्स आर गिवन, दिस टर्म्स इट इज गिवन एंड यू हैव टू ऐड, सो सेम इन द सिमिलर वे वी विल डू दिस क्वेश्चन आल्सो सिंप्लीफाई, सो 9x³ माइनस 10x³ प्लस 8q, सो इन द मेंटली आल्सो यू कैन डू, सो फर्स्ट वी विल डू इट बाय दिस मेथड, सो क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, सो इक्वेशन इज गिवेन 9x³ माइनस 10x³ प्लस 8x³, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एज व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू हैव टू राइट इन द कॉलम वाइज, सो हाउ यू विल राइट, फर्स्ट यू राइट 9x³, ओके, जस्ट बिलो यू राइट 10x³, ओके, जस्ट बिलो यू राइट 8x³, सो राइट हियर 8x³, ओके। नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू वी विल ऐड, ओके, सो नाउ फॉर द वेरिएबल्स x³ इज देयर, सो वी राइट द सेम x³, नाउ हियर इज द प्लस 9, हियर इज द प्लस 10 एंड हियर इज प्लस 8, सो there is no any confusion for the sign. So all are in the plus. So simply we can add 10 plus 9, 19. 19 plus, actually I have done mistake. There is the minus sign actually. Yeah, here is the minus sign. So here is the minus sign. Okay. So, sorry, I forgot. So now, first of all, we will see this one. So here is the nothing but plus sign. So plus 9 and 10. Minus 10. So plus minus minus. So 10 minus 9. So 10 minus 9 will be 1. And before 1, which sign will be there? Because the 10 is the greatest number. Before that, minus sign. So minus 1. Now minus 1 and plus 8 next we will do. Because the next is plus 8. This is nothing but plus 8. So now plus minus minus. Again between 8 and 1, there will be subtraction. So it will be 7. So before, and which sign will be there? 8 is the greatest number. So before that, plus sign. So plus 7. It means our answer will be plus 7x cube. So you can simply write 7x cube also. So this is your answer, 7x cube. Another thing you can do in your mentally also, in your mind also you can do. You can see these variables, the same type of variable, like terms are there. Okay. Now, in your mind you can add plus 9, minus 10. So it will be minus 1. Okay. Now minus 1 and plus 8. So in minus, you just subtract minus 1 in the 8. So what will be the answer? 7. Now you write the cube terms, this variable term. So 7x cube. So in the in your mind also you can calculate. So first of all you have to solve in this way, then you can do in your mind also. Okay. Next we will solve question number 3. Okay. So I am going to solve question number 2. So it's a, here I can do very easy this one. So here you can see, okay, here I'm going to solve question number 3. So question, that is number 2. 4m plus 6n, it is already arranged. Okay. So now 5m plus 2n. So how you will add? Simply this variable terms you write the same. And now 6 plus 2, 8, because already the plus sign, so there is no any confusion. Now here I will write the plus, because for this plus there will be plus plus plus. This 2 plus become plus only. So now m, this we will write the m only, and here is the 4 plus 5, 9, because there is no any other sign, so only plus sign. So your answer will be 9m plus 8n. Okay. Now one more question I will do, question number here. Okay, this question number 4. So there is a minus sign, so let's solve this question. So number 3, question number 4, minus 6x minus 2, there is then minus x minus 5, and what we have to do, we have to add. Now you can see here is this part, only 2 and 5 are there, no any variable, simply we can do. So how? First of all you have to see, there is the minus 2 and the minus 5, it means minus minus plus. So 5, between 5 plus, between 5 and 2, what which operation will be? Addition. So this 5 plus 2 became 7. Now see the greatest number 5, what, which sign is there? See, minus sign. So I will write here also minus sign. Okay. Now we will write the same for the variable x. So write here x, here is nothing but 1. Okay. If before x there is no any number, it means there is a 1. Now you can see minus 6 and minus 1, this minus 6 and minus 1, it means between 6 and 1 there will be addition. So 6 plus 1, 7, and which sign will be there? 6 is the greatest number, which sign is there? Minus. So right there minus. Okay, so what is your answer? Minus 7x minus 7. Okay, so likewise you can do this question number 3. All the these questions you can do, like this number 6, I just solve here. 8 plus, here you see cc, so write here c. 8 plus 7, write 15. Okay. Now there is a plus sign only, so plus plus became plus. Okay. Now here is the minus, here is the also minus, so minus minus plus. So it means there will be plus. So before C there is nothing, any digit, it means there is a 1. So 4 plus 1, it will be 5, and this variable, right, 5C square, and minus minus plus, and see that which is the greatest number, 4. What is the sign before that? Minus. So there will be the minus. So what is the answer? Minus 5C square plus 15C. Okay, so likewise you can solve question number 3. All the questions you can solve. Now we will solve question number 4. So in the 4 we have to add again. So here I am going to solve question number 3. 3 terms, different terms are there, and already it is arranged. So now we will solve question number 3. Question number 4, sub question number 3. So it is given x square minus 3x and plus 4. You have to write it properly, and just below that you have to write all the variables, same type of variable you write just below that. Okay, so write it nicely, and separately you write it, so there will be no any confusion. So there is a minus sign, okay, then after plus 5x, then after minus 2. And what we have to do, we have to add these all. So first of all we will do from here, always we are adding from right to left. Okay, so we will add these all first. So now you can see there is a plus sign, here is a plus sign. So 7 plus 4, that will be 11. No, plus 11, no, this plus 11 and minus 2, so plus minus minus, so 11 minus 2, it will be 9, and which sign will be there? Plus sign, because 11 is the greatest number. So here will be plus 11, so right here plus 9. Okay, now next we will do from here, these two we will do the first. So minus minus plus minus 3 minus, so that first you write the x, this x will be the same, you write the x. Okay, first minus 3 minus 2, so minus 5 will be there, because minus 3 minus 2, 5, then after again plus 5, this plus 5, so it will be 0, plus 5 minus 5, 0, so you write there 0. Then after which sign? You just use the plus sign. Okay, if it is 0, no problem, you write the plus sign. Okay, now here is nothing but 1. Okay, so now here plus 1 and plus 4, it is 5. Now here is what? Also 1. So plus 5 and then minus 1 also. Here we will do the next one, minus 1, so it will be 5 minus 1, 4. So first you write the variable part, x square, and it will be 4. So your answer is 4x square, 0x plus 9. So this is 0 term, so you can write it 4x square, and this term becomes 0, so no need to write, so 9. So your answer is 4x square plus 9. Okay, so in this way you have to do, only you have to take care of the plus minus. So that table is very necessary to understand, and you should remember that table, how to plus minus we are doing. Okay, and simple additions are there, and you have to write column wise all the variables just below that, same type of variable, and likewise you have to do. Okay, now next is there, now we will solve, see the next question from here. We will solve from question for number 5. Find the sum of, we will find the sum of, here I will solve question number 2. So you can see there are 3 terms given, different. So these are the 3 different expressions given, not terms, 3 expressions given, and these expressions we have to add, because term is a, this is 3 terms are given, sorry, 3 expressions are given, we have to add. So now we will add question number 5, number 2. So number 2, first of all we will write the first one. So write the first, that is given in the row form, you have to write in the column wise, 3y square minus 4y plus 5. Okay, now next is given 2y square, just below you write, just below the y square, because you have to write in the one column of for the same type of variable. Okay, so y square will be just below of y square, then after 7y, then after minus 1. Okay, now next is your only y square, so write y square, then minus 3y, write 3y, then minus 5. Okay, Now what you have to do, we will add it all. Okay, so same method we will follow here. First these two we will add, so plus 5 minus 1, it will be plus 4 only, and plus 4 and minus 5, so plus minus minus, so 5 minus 4 1, so write 1, and the minus sign will be there because 5 is the greatest number, before that minus sign. Now we write the variable y. Next minus 4 minus 7, so that will be 11, so 11, then again minus 3, so minus 11 again minus 3, okay, minus 11 and minus 3 again it will be added, so 11 plus 3 it will be 14, so write 14, and which sign will be there, minus sign, because before 11 it was minus sign, so 14. Now next is, you can see here is nothing but 1, so all here you can see in the plus form, all these are in the plus form, so 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, 6, so write 6y square, so your answer is 6y square minus 14y minus 1, that's your answer. Okay, now next we will solve here question number 6. Here I am going to solve question number 2. Okay, so here you can see it is not arranged, you can see y and 6, 2y, 7, so all they are not in arranged form. You can do in mentally also, you can see this y terms, square terms, you have to see the first. Okay, so these all the square terms we have to write first. So this square, so here I am going to solve. First I will write the all the square terms. So what are the square terms? 3y square, okay, next plus y square, so that is y square only. Next is your again this one minus y square, so minus y square, okay, then again one more minus y square, so write minus y square. So these all y square terms I have written here. Okay, now only y terms, you can see where is the y terms, only here is the minus 2y, so that minus 2y you write first, minus 2y. Okay, next you can see minus 3y, here is that minus 3y, so this minus 3y we write here. Next y terms is there anywhere? Yes, minus 4y, so write here minus 4y. Now we will write the constant term, so constant term is minus 6, then after plus 7, then after plus 5, so that all we will write in the one column form, so minus 6, okay, plus 7, then after, sorry, plus 7, then after plus 5. So now separately we will add these all. So here you can see, first I will add this one, so nothing but here is the 1, so 3 plus 1, 4, 4 and minus 1, 4 minus 1, 3, and then again 3 minus 1, that will be 2, so it means this part will be 2y square, okay, so now I got 2y square. Now here this y terms, so minus 2, minus 3, so it will be minus 5, minus 5, again minus 9, so it will be 9, and before that minus sign will be there. Okay, now here I got minus 9y. Now here you can add minus 6, plus 7 and minus 5, so here you will get plus 6. Okay, so now these 3 we have we got. Now I will arrange in the expression, 3 terms we have now, 2y square, 9 minus 9y and 6y. Now we can write in the form of expression. Yes, so now write 2y square minus 9y plus 6, so this is your answer, plus 2y square minus 9y plus 6. Okay, so what we have done here, we just taken out the same similar type of terms, okay, the similar types of terms, then we added, then after again we form the expression. Okay, now next here I am going to solve this question number 7. So p's value is given, 2a minus 5b minus 7c, and q's value is also given and r value is also given. So what you have to do, you have to p plus q plus r, means these three terms, these three expressions we have to add, these three values we have to add. So one by one you write the value and add. So first p value is given, what is the value is given? 2a, so write 2a minus 5b minus 7c, so this is the p's value is given. Now what is the q value? Q's value is 9b, so 9b always you have to write in, where is the 9? B, here is the b, so write here 9b. because I told that same type of the variables you have to write just below of that. Okay, so write here 9b. Next you can see minus 6a, so here is this a part, so write the 6a. So before 9 there is a plus sign, so write the plus. Now minus 10c, so write here 10c. Okay, now what about the c? Next one, what about the r? So there is plus 4a, so write there, sorry. Then after 17c, you write here minus 4b, so write here 4b. Okay, so just below of that you have to write the same type of variable. Okay, column wise you have to arrange. Now it is arranged, and now what we have to do, we have to add these all. Okay, so we just put the plus sign. Now minus 7, you can see here I can write the c for this c. Minus 7 and minus 10, minus 17, minus 17 and plus this plus 17. Here is not plus sign actually. Okay, now plus 17. So plus 17 means plus, it will be 0. So write here 0. Okay, now here will be the plus sign. Again, I will write the b first. Okay, now minus 5 and plus 9. So it will be minus, it will be the subtraction between 9 and 5, so there will be plus 4, so plus 4, and then after minus 4, so again it will be 0, so right there 0. Then plus, now here 6 plus 2 and 6, there will be minus 4, minus 4 plus 4, so it will be again 0, so this is 0a. So now what we got, 0a plus 0b plus 0c, it means this term became also 0, this term also became 0, this also became 0. So 0 plus 0, your answer is 0. Okay, so your answer is 0. So in this chapter, in this exercise, how you have to solve, you must know this table. Okay, this table is very important to solve this question. You must know these rules. These rules already I have attached here. You can see this rule also, or you can prefer, go to the page number 57, chapter 3, or you can see my previous video of that chapter. And you know, try to know this, and also you remember the rules for the subtraction also, because in the next exercise 14b we will study how to subtract, so there again it will be used. Okay, thank you.